Hello, I'm Eric Singer. This is Argonne's Public Affairs Science and Technology Past Fusion Cell Flash Briefing for the week of June 3, 2019.
Argonne supports a lot of full-scale preparedness exercises around the country, and one of the things that we've really noticed of late are delays in providing emergency information, particularly during that first 60 minutes right after the event. And that's probably been one of the most consistent and regular exercise observations that we've seen in recent years.
60 minutes on average, ticking away for someone else to shape your message, says risk communications specialist Brett Hansard with Argonne National Laboratory.
As public information practitioners, we can't afford to wait anymore to get all of our ducks in a perfect row. Of course, we always need to be accurate. First and foremost, accuracy always counts, but speed can't be sacrificed for completeness. Say as much as you can, as soon as you can, in the minutes after an emergency, and then just keep that conversation going. We recommend having a what we call a by time statement ready to go that acknowledges the event. And even if that statement is only to say, we know something has occurred and we're working as quickly as we can to gather the information, then please stay tuned. Another recommendation that that we make to sites is to have what we call evergreen material ready, in the can, ready to go. That's material that focuses on the topics you can talk about. Things like plans, policies, procedures, and protocols, we call those the four P's.
Also on your to-do list, prepare info sheets about your agency for immediate release. This stuff may already be on Wikipedia and not updated. Make sure the news media gets the information from you, the trusted source. Then there's the elephant in the room to feed, social media.
Recognizing that the media is a very important partner in getting information out to the public, but at the same time recognizing that there are a lot of ways through social media and other digital platforms to engage with the public directly. So I think in terms of getting information out quickly after an emergency, you need to reach both the public and the media simultaneously and continue to do so going forward. There's an old saying that a lie can travel halfway around the world before the truth can get its shoes on. And that was before social media took hold. So today, there's really too much opportunity for misinformation and confusion to take hold, and that can lead to bad decisions and bad outcomes for the public.
The talk to get your organization's bosses on board to add the four P's or by time statements to your emergency to-do checklist may be simpler than you think.
I would put information up there with, food, water, and shelter as far as critical items that need to be attended to immediately after an emergency occurs. What you can't do is just is leave an open vacuum, as we've seen, particularly nowadays with social media, that vacuum will be filled by somebody else, and the odds are that could be erroneous information that an agency wouldn't necessarily want out there. What people do expect and what they rightly demand is an acknowledgement and a sense that the right people are engaging on this emergency and are working hard to get the information out as quickly as possible, and at the same time taking whatever steps they need to take to keep people safe.
If you'd like to hear previous Alexa Flash briefings, like the Argonne Past Fusion Cell Facebook page and connect on Twitter and Instagram at Past Fusion Cell. You can also check out the Past Fusion Cell's online toolkit for useful templates and information. Go to pastfusion.gss.anl.gov. This is your Flash Briefing.